Greetings, Earthlings. This is a quick inbox review of a kit from Meng, the Mark A Whippet British Medium Tank. I've actually been after a model of this for some time. I found it a very interesting tank. And there has been a really old one knocking around, but with the centenary of the First World War, there's been a lot of new First World War tank kits. Now, TACOM did come out with a kit of this, but I've plumped for the Meng one. It looked like a much simpler kit, there's a lot fewer parts, and also it's really quite cheap. So I decided I'd have this one, and I thought you might like to take a look at it. So, inside the box, we have seven sprues in this tan styrene. We have a one-piece slide-moulded body shell and three sprues in black styrene. We also have a typical well-constructed instruction book and a set of decals. This is the body shell. It's a one-piece slide-moulded part. It's got lovely detail on all sides, and it forms really the engine compartment, and it's the bit that all the other bits kind of stick onto. This sprue holds the outer sections of the tracks as well as the exhaust pipes. This sprue contains the inner sections of the tracks, including the two big mud chutes. And here we have the floor of the whole tank, along with the fighting compartment, sides and roof. We're supplied with two of these sprues for mainly the running gear, with the sprockets and the idlers, the chain drive, engine vents, part of the tracks, more running gear, and these are the spuds that improve traction in wet mud. And we also get two of these small sprues that contain the Hotchkiss machine guns and ammo belts and mounts. The final plastic parts are three sprues, all containing the track links in black styrene. These are clipped together and should go together without too much trouble. And of course we have a decal sheet with markings for British, German and Russian vehicles. Meng's instructions are usually fairly good. These look good, nice saddle stitch booklet. Inside it starts with a potted history of the Whippet in Chinese, English, Japanese and Russian. Then there's a quick blurb about the Tank Museum, who helped Meng with the research for this kit. The construction proper starts with the body shell rather than the running gear. And you can see here that some of the parts actually are supplied as flat plates but need to be bent to shape. This is a slightly unusual way of doing things. I assume that Meng know what they're doing. Here again, for the fuel tank, the flat plates need to be bent. I'm hoping that the parts will bend cleanly, otherwise it's going to be a problem. They need to be cut apart and glued together. Then we get on to the assembly of the tank's running gear. And Meng are careful to point out that the wheels have to be added in a particular order. You won't be able to see them once the tracks are fitted, but I don't think they'll go together any other way. The tracks are fitted in step 15, they simply clip together. And the spuds, the sort of track grousers, are also added to rails that are fitted around the tank. There's a set of markings here for a tank that belongs to the Brussels Military Museum, and another one that is preserved at the Tank Museum in Bovington. But strangely, no guides are given for tanks that wear the German or Russian markings that are supplied on the decal sheet. Time for a look at some of the detail parts now. There's some very finely rendered parts like these tiny hooks. Those are the track spuds, track adjusters, and the chain drive. There's some lovely rivet detail here on the front of the fighting compartment. And you can see here also the grooves that you're supposed to bend this part along to make it conform to the right shape. There are lots of these ejector pin lumps. They're not just marks, they're like outy belly buttons. They're here as well. Very strange. The tracks are supplied as single articulating links. They do have a single ejector pin mark on the inside of each link, but you won't be able to see this once the tracks are assembled and fitted. You get four of these lovely little Hotchkiss machine guns with ammo belts. So there you have it, that's Meng's Mark A Whippet British Medium Tank. There is also a kit of this tank made by Tacom, and it looks like a more involved and probably more detailed build. But I quite like the look of this one. It looked very simple and straightforward, and it was certainly a lot cheaper. I think it's going to be a fairly quick and easy build, and it does seem to be of Meng's usual high quality. Meng kits I've built in the past have generally been very easy to put together. There are some slightly odd things about it, like those bendy panels, and also the way that there are decals supplied for German captured vehicles and also Russian vehicles, but they're not mentioned in the marking guides. But anyway, I think that's a very fine kit. I'm going to have fun, I think, building that. And I hope you've enjoyed the review, and I hope that you'll comment and subscribe if you haven't already. And I look forward to hearing from you. So, until next time, happy modelling and goodbye.